for the masochists out there that enjoy being punished with such titles like The Surge, Bloodborne, Hades, and Dark Souls.
Oh, it hurts.
We'll surely love Returnal. I'm not even going to pretend I understood the storyline, because I didn't. Even after beating it, I was left bewildered. Apparently there's a real ending. Yeah, don't you love when games pull this crap? A real ending. If you collect something, die 6 times at a certain spot, while patting your head and playing with your feet. Honestly, if I got the real ending, I'm sure I'll still be confused, so let's move on. Today we will focus on what made the game fun, in my opinion, and that's the gameplay. Get used to this cutscene, because you'll see it a lot. You crash land on an alien planet and must find a way to break the cycle that is your miserable existence of being stuck in this hellhole. Everything is trying to obliterate you, except these things. I don't know what's happening. Every time I die is a great band. And every time you die, you start back in the beginning, losing your upgraded weapon, items, everything is gone. You have zero, nada.
Nothing.
Nothing?
Nothing.
Well, kind of.
What?
You get to keep the suit upgrades, which is part of the storyline, but that's it. The combat in the game starts off timid, but gets progressively more challenging as you go. The game thankfully doesn't just throw everything at you in the beginning. The combat is the biggest seller for Returnal. It's adrenaline filled that tests your gaming reflexes and leave you either feeling accomplished when you survive in what seems overwhelming encounters, or beating yourself up for jumping left instead of right. After a while of trial and error of playing Returnal so much, you'll get so quick with your reflexes that it feels like you're having an out-of-body experience where your hands and the game are one. The map randomizes itself every time you start over, but it starts cycling through similar locations again, because I've definitely played through areas more than once, but still a cool concept in an attempt to keep the game from getting stale. The load time is practically non-existent. You can rush through each part of the level with no hiccup of load time. Exploring is a huge part of the game. You'll want to explore to find better items, weapons, upgrades, and expand your health by collecting Silphium. When you reach a boss fight, that's basically the game's checkpoint. When you inevitably die trying to fight these beasts, you can rush back to fight the boss, but again, you would be a fool not to explore around looking for better gear and powering up. Yes, you will probably die trying to gear up too, which is ironic since the whole point of gearing up before a boss battle is to hopefully prevent death.
Oh, come on!
But that's Returnal, baby. You either get good or go kick rocks. Would I recommend Returnal? Sure. I personally think it was a nice introduction to the PlayStation 5 exclusive library. I'm sure the storyline gets really deep and Christopher Nolan-like, where you finally get what it all means and end up weeping uncontrollably at its sheer brilliance. But honestly, like an old arcade machine from the 80s, sometimes a game is just fun for its gameplay. I enjoy the challenge and chaos that is Returnal. And that's
my two cents.